Good afternoon. This is Jud Burgess. Earlier this morning, I gave my 3 minutes to Mayor Margo and City Council. Was a very strange 3 minutes, I'll tell you right now. As you all know, has a personal vendetta against me, and he's always looking for a way to mute my mic or silence my free speech rights when it comes to opposing him and his agendas. Well, today, not 15 seconds into accusing my audio that feeds into the TV station and the computer so that people that are watching City Council Live can see what's going on and hear what's going on.
Good morning, Mr. Burgess.
I absolutely agree with Cassandra Brown. I think I believe that the mayor has obviously since day one been trying to find ways to stifle any kind of public free speech rights that we have, to include his little button that he likes to press on me to...
I didn't know this until I went to produce my video today, and I noticed that my audio was completely gone right after I accused him of having a button that he mutes me with. And I know it was... ...people in the back to go ahead and cut my audio. But as far as my mic within the City Hall meeting, it was working, so I thought everything was kosher. Apparently not. So anyway, what they're doing right now is they're attempting to limit what my message to the public at large. There's a lot of people, probably in the hundreds, maybe even more, that watch these things live on television and on their computers. And if they can't hear what I'm saying, then they're limiting my free speech rights to reach other people with my message. So anyway, please watch this video that I'm producing. I did get my 3 minutes in, and I recorded myself, so you're going to hear all of it. But you'll also see where they cut my mic off. I mean, cut my audio off. And I spoke about high taxes, and I was challenging Tommy Gonzalez, who was basically off base on what he was saying earlier today regarding El Paso not having the highest taxes in Texas, in America, actually. So please, do me a favor. Don't ever let people trample your rights as an American citizen, as an El Paso citizen, to speak your mind against the authorities that govern us. This is a great example of how far they'll go to avoid opposition and to try to stifle any kind of free speech against what they do.
Mr. Burgess.
Good morning. I absolutely agree with Cassandra Brown. I think I believe that the mayor has obviously since day one been trying to find ways to stifle any kind of public free speech rights that we have, to include his little button that he likes to press on me to
curb any kind of public input. And if it's oppositional to any agenda he has, he'll try to find a way to continue to just stop us. And so I'll be here just like Mrs. Sheck. You know, I have a lot of admiration for this woman. She's a widow. She's treated awfully by the mayor and other people and disrespected. But I'll be here just like she is to give my... No, don't cut my mic. Don't cut my mic. I'm not insulting anybody. I don't know if you... Okay. But anyway, to continue on, the reason I'm up here is after listening to this... presentation on taxes, I would have to say that I disagree with the city manager when he says it's irresponsible to say that El Paso has one of the highest tax rates in America. I would guess that he probably makes $300,000 a year. He's probably clearing that a year. He probably lives on the west side the way Mayor Margo lives on the west side. And so there's a bubble that people tend to live in when they live on the west side, or the Upper Valley, or Kern Place. They don't seem to understand how the rest of El Paso lives. People in El Paso live at, below, or above the poverty line, by and large. You got several hundred thousand people here that are just struggling to make ends meet. And so the biggest thing that he left out of his talk was that El Paso has some of the highest property tax rates based on our yearly income.
Mr. Burgess, this over here, city attorney.
Yeah.
That's not the topic you signed up to speak about, and so when
that's okay. I'm changing it right now. I even talked to this, the city clerk, saying that I was gonna. So I cleared it with her.
I do not authorize you changing the topic.
Well, I'm changing my topic myself, and I have the right to do that. Okay, I have the right to do that. So yes, I do.
Have a sign-in, and we ask you, and you said your topic today is the ethics.
Well, I have 3 minutes. I have 3 minutes, so I'm, and don't take that off my 3 minutes, because she just wasted around 45 seconds of my 3 minutes. So let's see if, I know, she just ate up 45 seconds of my 3 minutes arguing with me about my...
She's trying to once again get you to just follow basic adult rules. That's all we're trying to do. We give you the privilege.
You're wasting my time right now. You are wasting my time.
All we're doing is asking that you follow.
Look, I have the free speech rights to come up here for 3 minutes and talk about what I want to talk about. Now the thing is, when you say that we're paying the highest property taxes, that is absolute fact. You can find that on any website, in the Texas census, on anything. And to say that a house is valued at 250 but it sells for 500,000 is very irresponsible, because most people can barely even afford to pay their taxes around here. So I don't know, we had a 5.8% increase in our property taxes when everybody else had negative in their property taxes. So I don't know if you're suggesting that we go ahead and increase our property taxes, but we shouldn't do that. We live on fixed incomes around here. We have Mayor Margo, Noe, and Claudia Perez wanting to pass COs on us without any kind of input from us, without any kind of approval on our end, because you can't, figure out how to pay, get taxes done and finish projects, so you penalize El Paso citizens. That's fiscal abuse, We have $500 million in CO debt that was not approved by voters. That's one of the highest rates in Texas. Why? Because you guys keep sneaking taxes on us without our approval. Okay? Okay, thank you very much.
So do I.
Good morning, Ms. Chef. Can I proceed?
That's the first time I have attended 249 agendas. Here today is the 16th with your people. It's the first time in 2.5 hours to wait for a 3-minute speech. I'm gonna not say nothing today, but I'll be here next meeting, and I want 6 minutes. Thank you. Thank you.